Okay, hi everybody. How are you all? Doing great? Lovely. So today I am going to take your maths class. We are not going to do any art and craft, no drawing, painting. We will be learning maths today. Cool? So everybody, now you have to tell me what is 2 plus 1? 2 plus 1 is? Who can answer me that? 2 plus 1 is 3. Correct. Awesome. You all know it. Superb. Now who's going to count these fingers? How many fingers are these? 1, 2, 3. Correct? Superb. So you all are so good at maths. That's awesome. Very good. Then since you already know maths, then let us not learn maths. Okay? Let us get back to our own drawing and painting only. Cool? So today let us learn what you already told me right now. We will learn to draw with number 3. Okay? Let us see what all does number 3 teach us. Number 3 can teach us so many things. You know that? Let us quickly see what all can we draw with number 3. Okay, so now I'm going to move my screen to my paper where I'm going to draw, and I want you all to quickly keep all your supplies and materials ready. Okay, so you have them handy whenever you need them. So I want you to have few plain white papers or sheets where we will be drawing. Okay, I want you to have your pencil and eraser. I want you to have your black sketch pen. And I want you to have your crayons. Whatever crayons you have, they will do. You can use oil pastels, you can use wax crayons, you can use plastic crayons. Any color, any crayon is fine. Okay? All right, so now who is going to show me how to write number 3? I don't know how to write number 3. Who will show me how to write number 3? Okay, quite a lot of you are showing me. That's nice. Thank you for teaching me how to draw number 3. So, seeing at all of your papers, I think this is how we draw number 3. Correct? All right. Now, you know, I'll tell you one story. Once what happened, number 3, it has two hands. This is the one hand and this is the second hand. Both these hands said that we never get to meet each other. So how should we meet? They wanted to meet each other. So this hand said, okay, I will come a little forward and meet you here. Okay, so everybody extend this line and stop here. Done? Now the other hand said, I will also meet you here. So this hand also came here and they both met at this place. Okay, so let us color this place, their meeting place, with black. Okay, now when they both met, they thought, let us shake our hands. So they shook their hands. All right, they shook their hands. All right, I guess everybody has drawn this much. Okay, now they all, both of them had got some gift for each other. So this hand gave this one a gift and the other one also gave the other hand a gift. Both of them gave each other a gift on meeting. Okay, so I guess everybody has drawn till here. Okay, now when these two friends, they met, they thought, let us have an ice cream together. Okay, so they ordered a big ice cream. So let us make a big ice cream for them. Okay, the two friends are having this ice cream. Have you had an ice cream of this shape? Anybody? Have you had a stick ice cream? Yes? Which is your favorite stick ice cream? Tell me quickly, what flavors do you like to have in stick? Awesome. Somebody is writing chocolate, strawberry, butterscotch. Very good. Orange, mango. Lovely. I'm already getting the taste of all these ice creams in my mouth. I'm surely going to have one very soon. Okay, so even these two friends, they thought of having a ice cream together. Now they took such a big ice cream that they were not able to finish it. And this ice cream started to melt. Okay, and when the ice cream melts, it starts dripping. So the ice cream was dripping like this. Okay, it was falling down. Okay. And here we will make two little legs. Oh, what magic! What has number three helped us make? This is a mouse, correct? We have made a mouse using number three. Superb! So now you can color the mouse either in brown or in gray color, whatever you like. Or you can also use any color of your choice. Okay, there is no restriction on color. If you want your mouse to be red in color, you can also do that. Okay, so first take your crayon. And now let us start coloring our mouse. Use your crayon in one direction. Okay, and go slow. Your color should not go outside your drawing. Okay. So we go very slow on the borders and color your mouse nicely. Your white paper should not be seen when you are coloring. Okay, you should color with so much pressure that your color looks dark and your white paper is not seen. Okay, I hope everyone is coloring along with me. All right, like this you have to color the whole of your mouse, the body and the face of the mouse. Yes, the legs also. Yes, yes, you can color the eyes of the mouse in black. Okay, has anybody seen a mouse in real? Yeah, has anybody seen? Mouse are found in so many sizes, you know, big and small. I am very scared of mouse. Are you also scared or you like to play with mouse? Yeah? I am very, very scared of mouse. Okay, so in this way you can color your mouse. Color it nicely, because if you don't color your drawing nicely, then all your nice drawing will not look nice at all. You will spoil your drawing if you don't color your drawing nicely. So coloring is very important. Coloring makes your drawing looks beautiful, and it can even spoil your drawing if you don't color it nicely. Okay, so we have made our first drawing using number 3. Okay, I am waiting for you all to finish. Once you all finish, then we can move on to our next drawing. Okay. All right. Beautiful drawings. I can see quite a lot of you are showing me. Lovely. Very good. So I guess everybody now knows how to draw a mouse using number 3. Correct? Very good. Very good. Good going, everyone. All right. I guess everybody has finished coloring their mouse now. So let us move on to our next drawing. Okay, so let us move on to our next drawing. Now again, we will begin with number 3. So let us draw number 3 a little differently this time. Let the upper part be small and the lower part be a little big. Okay, the upper part is a little small and the lower part is a little big in size. Okay. I hope everybody has drawn number 3 like this on their paper. All right. Very good. Now, after meeting here, number 3, they came back to their house. Okay. Now, after you come back to your house, when you return from somewhere, what is the first thing that you do? You close your door, isn't it? So that nobody else can enter your house. Correct? So they also came and they closed their door. So you also closed the door for the upper curve. Okay? We have closed the door like this for the upper curve of number 3. Okay? And the lower part of number 3 had a door in a different direction, and so it closed its door like this. Okay, it closed its door like this. All right, and then they locked it with a key. This is the key. They locked their door with a key. Okay. After that, they switched on the fan. So just switch on the fan. This is the switch for the fan. Okay. When they switched off on the fan started moving. What shape does the fan move in? What is that shape called? Is it? It moves in which direction? In which shape? Circle, that's right. So let's make a circle here. The fan is moving like this. Okay. Can anybody guess what are we making? Yes, you can write what are we making in the chat box. Okay, now let us make a triangle here. Okay, make a triangle on the face of what we are drawing. Okay, quite a lot of you are guessing it right. We are drawing a bird. Does the bird have legs? Yes, it does. So let us make 2 legs for the bird. Okay, so draw 2 straight lines coming down. Draw 2 straight lines coming down. And make an inverted V here, like this. Okay. I hope it was clear how to make the bird using number 3. Okay, now let us color this bird in any color of our choice. Birds are so colorful. Yes, they are found in so many colors. So you can use any color of your choice that you like. Okay, now since the beak of the bird is red, can I color this in red? Okay, now I will color the eye in black. Okay, Now, what color should we do in the body? What color are you all choosing? All right. Everybody has a different choice. So, I am doing colors of my choice. You can do any color of your choice. Okay? See, I'm doing purple here. And then I will use pink in the other half of the bird. Okay, so half bird I'm doing in purple and the other half I'm doing in pink. You can also use two colors of your choice like this to give a shaded look to your bird. All right, coloring the face, the circle in pink. Okay, so I have finished coloring my bird and quite a lot of you are already coloring. I'm waiting for you all to finish coloring so that we can move on to our next drawing. So was it easy to draw this bird? Yes? Did you enjoy making this bird with number 3? Very good. Awesome. Very nice. All right. So everybody quickly finish making your bird so that we can move on to our next drawing. Okay, I'm waiting for you all to finish. Oh, very nice, very nice. I can see some of you are showing me your drawings. Beautiful colors. Very good. Good job, everyone. All right, so let us move on to our next drawing. Okay, so what are we going to draw next? Yes, yes, yes. Okay, I'm going to tell you very soon. So now, there was a number 3. Okay, let me draw number 3 first. There was this number 3 and number 3 was getting ready for a party. Okay, so it was standing in front of a mirror. Number 3 was standing in front of a mirror. This is the mirror. Okay, is everybody drawing? Have you drawn number 3? Okay, once you have drawn number 3, just join the two hands of number 3 with a straight line. Okay? Just join the two hands of number 3 with a straight line. Now tell me, when you stand in front of the mirror, what do you see? What do you see in the mirror? You see yourself, right? You can see your own reflection in the mirror, correct? So that is what even number 3 could see. When number 3 was standing in front of the mirror, let us make the mirror. Okay, so it could see itself on the other side. So let us draw the mirror image of number 3. So number 3 could see itself in the mirror, something like this. Okay, number 3 could see itself in the mirror, just opposite, in just the opposite direction. So this is the mirror image of number 3. Right? Oh yes, you are already guessing what I am making. Very good. Yes, yes, you all are right. This is a butterfly. So now since number 3 was getting ready, it wore a beautiful dress. Now the dress had some stripes on it. So let us make some nice stripes on the dress of number 3. Okay, make some stripes on the dress of number 3. Okay, you just have to make some lines in the center portion of the butterfly like this. Now the dress that number 3 was wearing also had some big dots of different sizes, circles. You can make some circles like this. It is wearing such a nice, beautiful designer dress. Yeah, it's looking so pretty. So you can make these circles on the butterfly wings. Okay, has everybody drawn the circles and the stripes to show the nice dress? Yes, you can make any other design also on the wings. Have you seen butterflies in real? They are in so many different colors and there are so many different patterns on the wings of the butterfly, isn't it? So you can make any design of your choice. If you don't want to make circles, you can make anything else as well. Okay? Your party dress, your design, you can make anything that you like. Okay? Now, since it was getting ready, it also wore a nice hairband on the top of its head. Okay. How many girls here have worn this kind of hairband, which has these two satellites coming out on the top of their heads? Yeah, it looks so cute, isn't it? We see a lot of people wearing this on Christmas. Right? Yes. So that is how the butterfly number 3 was getting ready, with a headband with two satellites. Okay, so we have finished making our butterfly, and since I just told you that butterflies are found in so many different colors, you can make your butterfly as colorful as you want it to be. Okay? You can do any color, absolutely no restriction on color. So let us start doing any color in your designs that you have made. If you've made circles, you can color them in any color of your choice. Okay, make your butterfly as attractive and as colorful as possible. Use as many colors. I have colored the dots or the circles that I've made in yellow. Okay, the center portion I'm going to color that with green. Okay, and the wings of the butterfly, tell me what color should I use? What color will look good? Let me use red. Okay. I want my butterfly to be very bright and colorful. That's why I'm using all different colors. Okay. Quickly, everybody, color your butterfly and show me how colorful you have made it. Okay, I hope everybody is coloring along with me. All right, awesome. Very good. Was it easy to make a butterfly with number 3? Could you all follow? Will you be able to make it on your own? Oh, great. Very good. Now color your butterfly nicely, show it to me, and then we move on to our next drawing. Okay, keep coloring nicely, everybody. Your color should not go outside your drawing, outside the outline that you have drawn for the butterfly. Okay, can you see how my color has not gone out of my outline? This is how you have to color your butterfly. Okay. Have you all finished? Show it to me once you are done. Very nice. I like the colors that you have used. Beautiful. Okay, I can see purple, pink, green butterflies. Very good. Good colors. And nice designs on the butterfly. Very good. You all have used your imagination. I like it. Good going, everyone. Okay, so should we move on to our next drawing? Yeah, should we move on? Okay. So, let us make number 3 just like we had made for the bird. Okay, so we will make a short head. Okay, a small curve and a big curve. Okay, this number 3 eats a lot of junk food. That's why it's got a big tummy. Yes, if you eat a lot of junk food, you will become very fat. And that is what happened with number 3 here. It ate a lot of junk food. I'll tell you in the story how this number 3 ate so much of junk food that it has a big tummy. Okay. So have you drawn this number 3 with a big tummy? All right. So now let us join the two ends of number 3 with a straight line. Okay. I have joined the two ends of number 3 with a straight line. Has everybody done that? Okay, very nice. Now you know what was the junk food that this number 3 ate. It had 2 burgers. One big burger, one small burger. 2 burgers it ate. And let us join these burgers from here. Okay, it ate 2 burgers. A big burger and a small burger. And when you eat burgers, what is it that you like to have along with it? Some ketchup, isn't it? So let us draw some ketchup here. Let us draw some ketchup with the burger. Okay, now after it had the burger, it was still hungry. Can you imagine? It was still hungry and it wanted to have even more junk food. So then number 3 ordered some french fries. Oh my god, how many of you like french fries here? Okay, a lot of french fries loving people here. Superb. So let us draw some french fries. One french fry here, the other french fry here, another very big french fry here, and one more french fry here. My god, so much of french fry this number 3 is eating. Yeah, that's why it's getting fatter and fatter. Now after eating all of this, number 3's tummy was full and that made it happy. So let us make a happy face. So let us draw an eye here, a big nose, okay, and we will make it smile. Okay, so what have we made here? We have made a rabbit. That's right. So you can color the rabbit in colors of your choice. Anybody who has seen a rabbit in real or in your books? Okay, what color is the rabbit in the books? It is very light pink in color or white in color, correct? So you can color, if we color it in white, we will not be able to see any color on our white paper, correct? So we can use some very light color like peach or pink. Okay, you can use any color to color this rabbit. So you take any color, a very light color, and color the whole rabbit in the same color. Okay, I am doing peach color here. You can also use peach and pink both. You can erase the line that is coming here in between this burger, the legs of the rabbit. Okay, since I have drawn it with a marker, I am not able to erase it here. But you are drawing with pencil, so you can erase it. Okay, color your rabbit nicely. You can color the tail with another color, like I just colored it with pink. Okay, you can also color the inside of the ears with pink, like this. Okay. I hope everybody is drawing the rabbit and you all have started coloring it too. All right. Let me know once you are done. Okay, just write done. So I'll know how many of you have finished. You can show me your drawings on your screen. Okay, I'm waiting for you to finish. Keep drawing, everybody. All right, very nice, very nice. I can see some of you are showing me your paintings. Drawings. Beautiful. Very nicely you've done. Good job. Very good, very good. You all are quite talented. Yeah, you're all doing it so well. Very good, everyone. All right, so should we move on to our next drawing? Yes? All right. All right, so now what are we going to draw? Now again, let us begin with number 3. Okay, so in the same way like we just drew our number 3 for the rabbit, we will draw another number 3 with a small head and a big tummy. Okay, a small head. Okay, so we have drawn this 3 with a small head and a big tummy. Okay, just made this head tilt towards this side. Okay, now this is Mama 3. Okay, this is the mummy of number 3. That is why it is so big. Okay. And now we are going to draw baby 3. Okay. So I hope everybody has drawn mama 3. Done, everyone? All right. So now let us draw baby 3. So baby 3 is here. So draw baby 3 here. Okay. So there was Mama 3 and Baby 3. Mama 3 and Baby 3 were sitting inside their house. So close the door of the house. Okay. Has everybody made till here? All right. Then Mama 3 made jalebi for the little baby. So make a jalebi. Yeah, you like to eat jalebis? I'm talking a lot about food today, isn't it? All yummy foods, ice cream and burger and french fries and now jalebis. Yeah. All right. So now we are eating jalebi. Okay, so number 3 wanted to put it on the plate. So Mama gave a big plate. So draw this big plate. Just draw a straight line like this and a small sleeping line. Okay. Have you all drawn this much? Done. Who's going to guess what is this? All right. Very good. Good. Good going. And now here we are going to draw a tail, a big tail. This is like a big jalebi, isn't it? All right. And because Mama made jalebi, so this baby 3 was very happy. So let us make a happy face. So I'm making a eye and a smiley face. And what have we made here? It is a monkey. Correct? All right. So let us color our monkey. What color should we do in the monkey? Who has seen a monkey? Monkeys are what color? Yes, monkeys are brown in color. That's right. So let us color the body of the monkey in dark brown. And you can color the face of the monkey in light brown. Okay? So everyone color along with me. Color your monkey nicely. Okay, your color should not go outside the line. Always color in one direction. Okay, so like this, finish coloring your monkey in dark brown color. Even this portion of the monkey will be in dark brown. Okay, and inside we are going to do light brown inside the face of the monkey. So here I am doing light brown. Okay, I hope everybody could draw the monkey with me. Yeah, everybody could draw the monkey. It was quite easy to draw this monkey with number 3. Right? Great, great. So quickly finish making the monkey and then show it to me. Okay, everybody quickly finish making the monkey and show it to me. All right, beautiful, beautiful drawings. Very good, everyone. I love the way you are all following the instructions and drawing along with me. Very good. Very good, very good. All right. So just let me know once you are done so that we can move ahead and make the last drawing for our session today. Yes, I'm waiting for you all to finish coloring your monkey so that I can move ahead. Done. Should I move on to my next drawing? All right. Okay, now this one is going to be very cute. Okay, now just like we had drawn number 3 with a small head and a big tummy, but this was big in size. But the same thing we will draw here, a little small in size. Okay, so a small head and a big tummy. Okay, number 3 with a small head and a big tummy. Okay, now the two ends of number 3, after they met once, they started liking meeting each other. So we used to meet quite often after that. Okay, so one more day they thought of meeting each other. So number 3 went down to the other hand's house. Just like you go to your friend's place to play at times. Just like that, this hand of number 3 also went down to play with this other end of number 3. When they met, they gave a high five to each other. Do you give a high five to your friend? Yes? How do you give a high five? You show one hand and your friend shows you the other hand and then you both give a high five. Correct? So, they also gave a high five. So, just let us make some fingers like this. Okay, because they gave a high five. So, we have shown a hand here. Okay, then draw one eye, draw a triangle, and draw two legs coming down. Done? Have you done this much? Now draw two inverted V's like this. Okay, do you know what is the baby of a hen called? It's called a chick. So we have made a chick here. What is the color of the chick? It is yellow color with red wings. So we are going to color this with yellow. So everybody take your yellow crayon and color the body of the chick with yellow. Okay, like this, color the body of the chick with yellow and we will color this wing or the feathers in red. Like this and also the beak in red. Okay, so we have finished making the chick also. Okay, I hope everybody could make. All right, finish your coloring nicely. Okay. I guess you all enjoyed. Did you all enjoy making all these drawings with number 3? We made so many. You can make so many more drawings with number 3. See, what all did we make today? We made a monkey. We made a chick. We made a mouse. And a bird. And we made a butterfly. And a rabbit. Right? I hope you all could make all of this. Yes, now anybody wants to show me their drawings? Yeah? You can put it up on the screen and I would love to see. Oh, very nice, beautiful drawings, huh, everybody? So very nicely made, and I love the color choices. Beautifully colored, so colorful. Very good. Good job, everyone. Very nice. All right. So see, we made 6 drawings using number 3. There are so many more things that you can draw with number 3. Look around yourself, not just animals and birds. Look for more things that you can draw with number 3. Okay? There are so many more things. I'm not going to give you any clues. But if you feel you can draw something else, do draw and post your pictures. And post pictures of these drawings as well that you have drawn in today's class on our Facebook and Instagram page. And I would love to see all of your drawings. Okay? So keep posting and keep drawing. I would love to see more drawings from all of you with number 3. Show me what all you can make. It can be anything apart from animals and birds. You can make flowers with number 3. Okay? You can make a squirrel with number 3. There are so many things. Just look around yourself and see what all can be made with number 3. Use your imagination. All right? Thank you everybody for joining the class. It was a pleasure having you all and drawing with you all. Yeah, thank you so much. Bye-bye. See you all again next time.